Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. But Jacob's name was later changed to Israel.
He wrestled with an angel.
He actually wrestled with an angel, and that's when he got the name Israel, Yahshua, which means he is the Prince of Power. And that's who we are, Israelites. And that's why them goddamn devils overseas is claiming to be us, because they know the benefits of being an Israelite. So they erased out of our minds, out of the Israelites, the true Israelites, they erased out of their minds who they really are. And they took on the identity of Israelites.
Let me get that for you.
All right, bro.
Revelation 2:9. I know that works in tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know
the blasphemy
of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
Identity thieves.
Yeah, that's them right there.
You ain't got the stripe pocket yet?
God bless y'all, man.
Damn, shit. Kill your ears, man. I heard him.
He's lukewarm.
You dirty, no good.
Gotta be downtown. Oh. Gotta be on campus.
Damn, so funny.
Tell about your boy. I heard your boy.
Oh, well, he told this, man. Oh, yeah. What'd he say, more women?
No, he made a post. He said more women are in the truth than men.
Why am I going? See, he's confused, man. He ain't got proper instructions. You know, just because more women gonna get delivered don't mean they're in no truth. Ain't no woman in no truth. I hope y'all saying something to him, man.
We've been trying some. It's too late.
Yeah. I don't want to try to talk to him. Teach
You're
him
right.
No more.
Vex him more. You know?
He just went to jail over a woman.
Vex him more. Fighting that bitch.
I was bugged out, man, when I heard that shit.
When I first got down here, it was so damn packed down here. The next thing you know,
they got the Joseph Smith show going on.
That's what's going on.
Cause we drove by.
It's a play.
Something. I drove by. I told him. I just yelled at Joseph Smith's a big old faggot. They had this big fat cop doing donut duty. He weighed about 300 pounds, didn't he?
Wow.
He's just a big.
That's what he was walking.
Yeah, there's a lot of people over here. That tells you there's a lot of Mormons in this city.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you know, because you know there's a giant Mormon temple right there on campus. That's why we always see them.
I might have seen it, though.
I seen it yesterday. If you go down a little, it's over there by Lane.
Right.
I think. Or not Lane. I forget what street that is. It's right past a couple streets.
I know where it is.
Past Eddie Jordan. That's it. What the church, the Latter-day Saints, we call that a church of the LSD. Because you gotta be high on acid to believe in that shit.
Right, straight up.
Some Mormonism. That shit is fucked out, man. And you know the Mormons, they gotta wear special underwear. You know that? The man, they got this special undergarments they gotta wear. Like, the magical underwear.
What the fuck is he wearing?
How long you been out here?
25, 30 minutes. I was already here when we touched
on. I had to drive all the way out to damn Grove City.
That's some crazy looking shit right there.
Go from church. That's nasty.
What happens when you go to church?
What's up, man? Where you from?
Right here.
What are your nationality?
Nationality? Yeah. Biracial.
You biracial, your mom's, your dad's black, your mom's white.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It don't matter what your mom is, what your dad is.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? So you are an Israelite, you know.
Yeah.
For your sake, you better hope you are.
Because
there are a lot of tares out there that look like brothers. You know what a tare is?
Yeah.
A tare is a weed that don't belong around the plants. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So when you grow a garden, right, you grow carrots and tomatoes and whatever you like to grow, the weed.
Yeah.
While it's growing, there's weeds that's growing up around it, right?
Yeah.
And there's amongst our people are actually weeds that look like us but ain't us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, let me get
but you, I can tell by your spirit you were one of us anyway, though.
Hey, let me get that. I got that scripture talking about those tares.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, man.
Yep. Matthew 13:37. He answered and said unto them, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. But the tares are the children of the wicked one, the Satan.
Hey, you know what the motherfuckers, false groups teach, that when it says let them grow together, I can't quote off the top of my head, but when the secret says let them grow together, them motherfuckers got to say it, they say it means that Esau can come in.
Oh, that's crazy.
You know, they saying that since they're saying let them grow together, he's saying they can come in and be part of camps. And,
yeah, that's fucked up.
Yeah, right.
Because they actually know who Esau is.
Yeah.
And, but they say, but here it is, they know who Esau is, but they still say Esau can be saved.
Mm-hmm.
How can you knowing who Esau is say something so ridiculous?
Right.
Esau is the devil.
Man, he's condemned forever.
The scripture, yeah, that means they saying prophecy holds no weight.
Yes.
Because the prophecy said that Esau got to go, and he's going to be destroyed.
Right, here we go. This is Malachi. I'm just going to start at the top anyway, 1:1. Malachi 1:1, the burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, said the Lord, yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, said the Lord, yet I love Jacob. And I hated Esau, and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness.
So the Lord said he hates Esau. And the Most High is not the author of confusion. So if he said he hates Esau, that means he hates Esau.
That's right.
It don't mean nothing else.
Right. Whereas y'all seen that video when motherfuckers is actually teaching that he's going to be employed in the kingdom?
That's true.
That's some bugged out shit, man. Like, he's going to be walking around, clocking in, clocking out, going home.
The fuck?
You know, going to the bar after he's working.
That's
crazy, man. What's wrong with these people, man? Whereas Edom said, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus said the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness and the people against whom the Lord have indignation forever.
Forever. Forever. What does the word forever mean? Hey, hold on. Let me get my dick. I'm not really sure what that means.
Which one? What you looking at? Forever?
Forever.
Yeah, because it seemed like it's some simplicity to it, but it's not. I guarantee it.
So what it said, the Most High has indignation against...
That's what I'm looking for, indignation.
Esau forever?
Forever.
Oh, I can look up both words right here. I got the big boy right here. Oh, let's do indignation first. Okay. See how fast I can get it.
Ooh-wee, man.
It's a beautiful day to teach the word, ain't it?
Beautiful day to vex the students. They hate us out here.
Yeah.
They hate us coming out here.
Seems like, it's like people more, there's more truth getting out here, though.
Yeah.
Because more and more people know about Israel now. Because like your boy was just talking about, he said that how the other Israelite groups don't teach this shit the way we do it.
Yeah, they don't talk to white people. And he meant all of them. It can be an actual brother that got a beautiful spirit on him, but don't look like us. And they just won't even give him the word, man. Won't even tell the brother he an Israelite until he passed by the true prophets, you know.
It's an indignation is a bad word, check this out. Indignation, all right? Anger aroused by something unjust, mean or unworthy. It comes from the Latin word, dignus. Now, if you add in to the beginning of dignus, well, the word dignus means worthy. So if you add the word in before dignus, that means unworthy. So it means Esau is unworthy.
Oh, shit.
What is worthy? It means worth. Esau has no worth. He has no value.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Look, it's 6 o'clock. 3 o'clock.
People come in people's camps, though.
4 o'clock. 5 o'clock.
Oh, my.
Yeah. That's
nasty. All right.
What's wrong?
Don't that thing right there. It's going to be destroyed.
Other thing going to be out here. That thing. It's only coming down here to get condemned. You know, Most High probably got us down here just to condemn that thing.
Probably out here putting work in, because you know, I bet the transsexual prostitutes make more money than the women.
Yeah.
Guess how foul people are.
Because
these people, they paid more for some freaky shit. You know what I mean?
And I must agree. The freakier, the nastier, the more you're going to get paid.
Yep.
The more you're going to get on top. Let me read this in Hebrews. You finish with that.
Yeah, I was just going to get the forever next.
Okay, let me read this. Hebrews 12 and 16. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person. Profane.
Profane come from the Latin word fanus. Fanus means temple. So profane means outside of the temple.
Out of there.
So that means that Esau got nothing to do with the temple of the Most High.
That's right. That's right. And we that temple. So ain't no motherfucking devil supposed to be around us.
Hell no.
No, I don't give a fuck motherfucker buying a 6-pack or 12-pack.
No.
Hell, a keg. Yeah, but you do got the money to buy the shit. I'd rather go collect pennies than go drink with that motherfucker, man.
Yeah.
At least there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright.
Look, that's a male. Ooh,
you know?
That's
the same spirit as 2/3 of Israel. The same spirit as Esau, who didn't give a damn about his birthright. These goddamn heathen Israelites don't give a damn about the birthright. They can care fucking less.
Yeah.
Goddamn heathens.
They get mad if you call them an Israelite. Someone an Israelite, that's like you called them a bad word.
A nigga.
Yeah.
Call them a nigga, some trash, whatever, you know.
They throw that name back at you.
Right. Well, like you done talk about their mama to her face. They take offense to that. Well, you know, that's cool.
That's just like Dave's aunt. That one day we told her she was an Israelite, and she called the cops on us.
She flipped.
Came to our house, trying to break her windows and everything. Like, I know y'all in there.
She's trying to rescue Dave.
She's banging on. Let me in. I know you in there.
Right.
I'm calling the police.
Right.
She calling the cops while she's trying to bust our windows out.
That's crazy. That's a black woman for you. Here you go. For ye know how afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing, he was rejected, for he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully with tears, crying like a bitch. Goddamn Esau.
Yeah, Esau is a big fact.
Esau, man, that's what we're talking about, Esau.
There's nothing manly about Esau.
Goddamn thing. He's manly when he got a fucking 12 gauge in his hand. When he's up in some jet, cause that's usually who's flying those jets. Those military jets, it's Edomites.
Yeah, cause the scriptures say Esau, the Lord has indignation against Esau forever. And the definition of forever is for everlasting time, eternally, at all times, incessantly. It's pretty self-explanatory now, ain't it?
Yes, sir.
But Esau can be saved, right? Even though the Lord hates him forever. So who should we listen to? Should we listen to these people teaching that madness, or we should listen to the Bible?
Yeah, that's some amazing shit, man. And they don't even get on their conscience, man, when a so-called white person walk up and want some answers. Because I'm sure they got some bullshit signs with them. I don't know.
I ain't
never really noticed they had signs with them. Because this draws people in, man.
Signs, yeah.
You know, whether though it's from the people, the purple people eaters, or the one in the red that look like, you know, a disco band.
Yeah.
You know, it will draw people in. People want answers, man. And they don't even want to talk to hell. They don't want to talk to us. When we went without, we had no garments on, but we was coming sincerely.
That's what the Lord told Peter. He said, you got to feed my sheep.
Yep.
But the sheep was hungry.
That's right. Freely give, freely receive. Freely receive, freely give.
Yep.
I'll give Sodomite was the first one. Oh, let me look at it. Hey, man. I couldn't stop from getting drunk after Prince died.
Yeah.
You know, he got so much love, man. So much love, man.
After he got murdered.
People don't see how wicked an androgynous is.
He's a Jehovah's Witness, too.
I don't know what the fuck the motherfucker was. But
you remember,
he
claimed to be a Jehovah's Witness.
Yeah, he was an androgynous. He was a witch.
Yeah.
You know, people that sold their soul, eventually, they don't think that eventually the devil will come collect that soul. Dumbasses. And that's what they came and got.
And you see the record sales after he died. He had like all the, on iTunes, he had all the top songs. They made a killing off of his death.
Oh, hell yeah. And check this out. His crackheaded sister's going to inherit everything.
Oh, my.
And they said this man, I already knew he did. Because I heard many concerts of this man perform songs that he never put out on album.
Yeah.
And they said he got a vault of music. A vault of music.
He didn't want the record labels to get a hold of
profit
none of
from
it.
That was his. But now we gonna get it all. Well, we probably won't get it all. Let me read this real quick. This is the definition of Edom in the Bible dictionary. Edom figures prominently in the prophetic scriptures as a scene of great future judgment. She is the only neighbor of the Israelites who was not given any promise of mercy from the Most High. Motherfuckers crying. There's been suicides. All for Prince, man. A goddamn androgynous. Who his lyrics? Actually, he's considered a prophet to these people.
Really is.
You know, he taught the people, teach the people that you ain't man or woman. You make some shit out sense out of that. What's that mean? You ain't man or woman. You ain't man or woman.
That's like your. That's why Dave Chappelle was clowning on him. He's looking all pretty and shit.
Yeah, he liked that Dave Chappelle too.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he loved it. He loved it. Actually, Dave Chappelle didn't dog him. Just made some comedy out of that madness. Prince.
Crazy. That came out of nowhere, too. They weren't ready for that one.
But it's kind of spiritual. It's weird in a way, because remember, just a couple weeks ago, Apostle Tahar brought out the video saying that Prince is Amadeus.
Really?
Yeah. Just like last week.
Oh, for real?
And then this happens. putting the attention of the angels on these fools, man. That's what we're supposed to do.
Because we've been said that more celebrities are going to start dropping dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
It's the season, bro. This is the season of death.
Alex Jones was going, yesterday and today, he had mentioned a little bit about what the witches is doing right now.
Yeah. Oh, we're getting close to May Day.
Yep, Alex mentioned it a little bit.
Yeah, because it's that time of year right here, towards the around May 1st, going into and around it.
Yep. Let's just pray some more happen, man.
There's another big blues star died. Was it Lonnie Mack?
I can't remember the name, man. Because they got him on. There's a video. They got them both on there, side by side.
Yeah.
Yeah, they dropping dead. China, the wrestler, the female wrestler.
China just dropped dead. China. Earlier than that, you had Merle Haggard drop dead. Motherfucking David Bowie. Lemmy from Motorhead. There was more than that. I can't remember. There's so many, I can't remember them all.
Right, the bitch that used to be with Prince.
Apollonia.
I can't remember the name, man. Damn.
Oh, that's your girl.
Vanity.
Vanity. Whoa. Her name was Vanity.
right. Yeah. That bitch was a serious cokehead, man. Serious ass cokehead. Oh, let me get this.
So we pray more you fools start dropping dead, man.
Let's see if I can find the scripture.
But I already got a search engine open.
Okay, I got it.
Let me get that scripture. Vanity. I'm just gonna do a search on vanity. Cause Prince was a vain motherfucker, man. Trying to look pretty all the time.
Gay. What's that? Psalms, all men are vanity.
Vain.
Wait a minute, I'm tripping.
All men together, walking the vain show, some shit. Vain show. Probably how it goes. Vain show or something.
What book you said?
Songs. All together, something like that.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna get it.
Oh yeah.
I barely see this.
Hold on, I think I know something.
Yeah.
There's some shit going down, man. And I don't understand how a motherfucker can't be. I mean, can't be fired up watching this shit going down, man.
Shit.
Most High is doing so much, it's gonna get to the point they're gonna know it's him. Right now, shit just happening, they don't have no answers for it. It's just a death. It's a celebrity death. Let's go to the funeral. Let's go all mourn together and get drunk afterwards. They're not even thinking that what's going on is this is the Most High starting to get busy.
Because really, Prince is a nobody, actually.
Nobody, that's right.
He can play guitar. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? What does that do for us? It don't do nothing.
Shit, there was five major earthquakes in like different places of the earth.
Oh yeah, because they say the big one's about to hit the West Coast. I heard Putin was getting troops ready for emergency aid because they was fearing a tsunami. Because if an earthquake's hitting the Pacific region, that's gonna cause tsunamis.
They said 171 nations is preparing for that. 171 nations. It's getting ready for some big class. I don't know.
Cataclysm.
Some type of cataclysm. Right. I'll be getting tongue twirled all the time. tongue twister. I can't look on this phone. I gotta go on my Bible.
Shit,
Psalms 26 and 4. That might be it. Hold on.
Welcome, runners.
Oh, shit, this is cool. Here we go. This is Psalms 26 and 1. Judge me, O Lord, for I have walked in my integrity. I have trusted also in the Lord, therefore I shall not slide. Examine me, O Lord, and prove me. Try my reins and my heart. For thy love kindness is before my eyes, and I have walked in thy truth. I have not sat with vain persons, neither will I go in their disassembly. Go with disassemblies. I have hated the congregation of evildoers. I would not sit with them.
We were just saying that, bro. Even that's talking about Jake, probably, but. And we, like he was saying earlier, we ain't gonna kick it with Esau even if he buys us a drink. You know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna catch us hanging out with fucking these evil motherfuckers, man.
This is crazy. What you looking for? Tissues. It wants to come out.
Yeah, you ain't supposed to be hanging out with 2/3 and drug dealers and shit. I mean, you can try to give them the truth. You know, because the Lord kicked it with sinners. But some people, they'll take that scripture and run with it. But the Lord hang out with sinners and prostitutes. And they'll use that as an excuse to go and just be wicked as hell. You know what I mean?
Yep, that's the, right. That's just a vain attempt to not cast off that old man. Niggas can't take change. I will not sit with the wicked. I will wash my hands in innocency. So will I compass thine altar, O Lord, that I might publish with the voice of thanksgiving and tell of all thy wondrous works. Hold on, let me try and find the scripture.
Fucking sun.
Yeah, you can't see shit out here.
Nigga looks familiar.
First John goes into it. 1 John 2:15, where it says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
That's the spirit.
For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of the Most High abideth forever. Little children, it is the last time, and as ye have heard, that Antichrist shall come.
Ain't they kind of pushing that now? Because they pushing something with this Antichrist. If you're hearing it more and more now.
Everybody's saying we in the biblical age. The apocalypse of Armageddon is coming.
Right, because they trying to put Lincoln in with Planet Nibiru or Planet X, whatever the fuck you want to call it.
They just can't come straight with it, as the scriptures say.
Yeah.
They always got to add unto the words.
Yeah, something's going to come with that, man. I'm just excited waiting, man. What's gonna come around, cause you're hearing it more and more, the Antichrist is about to show his face. And I'm wondering who the hell, of course it's gonna be the one that looked like this fact. What's his name, the Rothschild? What's his name? That's not David, is it?
Oh yeah, he looked just like you.
Yeah. Is it David?
Yeah, David the Rothschild.
Looks just like this fact.
Yeah, he's the, when his dad dies, he's going to be the top guy.
Top man. Probably going to assassinate his ass.
I'm surprised he ain't killed him already. Yeah, that's how Esau gets down. Yeah, he kills all of his family members so he can be on top.
Yeah. They got to have their own separate guards and shit protecting them, and they don't trust each other.
Hell no.
That's a fine motherfucker right there, boy. The plastic Jesus. That's what they call him, the plastic Jesus.
I was even talking to somebody yesterday who didn't know nothing about the Bible, and they was talking about they showed me a picture of Caesar Borgia.
Right.
I'm like, that ain't the Lord. I was like, that ain't what the Bible said he looked like. And he was like, oh yeah, I read that once that he had hair like wool. You know what I mean?
Right.
Don't even know the Bible, but he knew that the Lord didn't look like that.
Amen.
Yeah, but this scripture right here says, for all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. It's not of the Father, but it's of the world. That's what your boy Prince was all about, man.
Right.
He's looking all pretty and shit. Maybe wearing mascara and shit, wearing makeup. He powdering his face up before a show.
Wear skinny, tight-ass
pants.
wig heels.
Dressed in purple.
Women's jewelry.
Yeah, it's just...
You know, my best friend in high school was dressing like Prince, man. He was literally dressing just like Prince every day, man. Thank God the Lord distanced us from each other.
And he had pictures of himself all naked, butt naked.
Yeah, this is an album. It's an actual fucking album.
Oh, but then your boy, he tried to go hard, thinking spiritual like that. That picture of Prince, he got three eyes, his third eye.
Yeah, Third Eye Girl, that's his new group.
Oh,
well,
okay.
That was his group, Third Eye Girl.
Okay.
Here you go, this is Psalms 39 and 5. Behold, thou hast made my days as a handbread, and my age is as nothing before thee. Verily, every man at his best state is altogether vanity, Salah. Surely, every man walketh in a vain show. Surely, they are disquieted in vain. He heapeth up riches, and knoweth not who shall gather them. And now, Lord, what wait I for? My hope is in thee. Now, all these motherfuckers that sold their soul, that the people are fucking losing their goddamn minds because they dropped dead.
They sell their soul just so they can get some temporary riches. You know what I mean? Some shit that you can't even take with you when you drop dead.
Nothing. Right.
It's just like, hey,
the Pharaohs borrowed this shit with them.
And it reminds me of that scripture, too, that I was just watching Elder Tahar's video earlier today. He just put out on Polite. Did you see that one?
Nah.
He brought this scripture out right here. It's just fresh in my mind. Talk about those riches.
Polite ain't dead yet.
Polite, he gonna be there soon, bro.
Yeah, he got a bad day coming. He got evil times coming, boy.
Look, check this out. Proverbs 22 and 1. A good name, and it's got good in all capital letters, too. It says a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches, and loving favor rather than silver and gold.
Woo!
Hey, that tells you a lot right there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So these people, they go sell their soul, do all kind of wickedness just to get riches. And these riches, they ain't going to satisfy your soul anyway. Yeah, because all these people, they going to be out here, you know what I'm saying? They sell their soul to get some money, but then that money don't even make them happy.
Hell no.
The money don't make you happy. So what's that old saying? More money, more problems.
Right. How rich Michael Jackson was? Yeah. What do you stay high on?
In that fentanyl or whatever?
Woo! That's crazy, man. All that riches, man, when they can be out enjoying it, like riding horses, canoeing, doing healthy shit. These motherfuckers stay high, man. And for what? That's their conscience after they done sold their soul. Their conscience is eating them alive, man. Eating them a fucking alive, especially after they done sold their soul and bent over. And started and sucked it or something and got something inserted up in them. What's up? What did you say? Y'all got alcohol from the goddamn corner. Get away from here. This is my life.
No, that ain't gonna happen.
I was hoping though. Oh man.
They would if we went up inside of their little spot.
Yeah. Those are adversaries.
Those are our adversaries.
No. These some shameful people, man. They're ashamed.
Satan's army.
Yeah, right.
Satan got a large army, man.
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Yes, he do. Deep. They deep.
That is why they call Legion, Legion. You know what I'm saying?
Deep.
He said, well, what's your name? Legion, for we are many.
Hold on.
You know, Rome, Legion, that was the name of the Roman army. It was a Legion.
Where does that broad is the way? And the
oh, yeah, that's Matthew 7.
Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta walk that tightrope.
Yeah.
But they get ran over.
The wind again. Here comes the wind again.
Here go the wind.
Who's in the wind? Here we go. Okay. This is Matthew 7 and 12. Therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, do ye even so to them. For this is the law and the prophets.
Hey, hold on. Yeah, because that's the golden rule. But do people live by that? That's what you're supposed to... Like he said, that's the law and the prophets. That's like the basis of the whole law.
The law?
No, the golden rule. But
the law.
People don't follow the golden rule.
What? He said the law?
The law. What? The law, man.
You do unto others as they do unto you.
That's right, that's right.
What?
But these people, man, these people are like animals.
Woo, you can't be good to these people.
Hell no.
We're being good anyway, giving them the word, you know.
So, yeah, we ain't going to treat people like shit.
Right, right.
But we're surrounded by piles of shit.
Mm. And it smells like it, it looks
it
like
does,
it.
It does too, man.
Yeah, that's right. You know, if a duck quacks and whatever, it's a duck. It ain't no chicken or a roost. I don't know how the saying goes.
Yeah.
You know, they're piles of shit. They're piles of shit with fleas all in it. Fleas and ticks. Fleas and ticks.
Yeah.
What's up, bro? I thought they was gonna start. Here you go. Enter ye at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. Like he says, Satan got a huge army, and it's deep.
Yeah, because broad is the way to lead to destruction. Broad meaning... broad meaning, you know, you just doing whatever you want. You walking out, you know, our people, they walking down the street smoking weed, just getting drunk out of their mind, getting fucked up.
You said weed. I thought it was harder shit than that.
Oh shit. Well, I'm just saying, yeah, they popping pills. They sniffing Oxycontin. They do it all, bro.
You know?
It is cold. Just the other day, man, I hear some niggas walking down the street. I'm looking for some Dilatus. I'm looking for some Dilatus.
Oh, them, yeah.
That's some potent shit.
That was that.
Potent. It started out giving, when a woman have a C-section, it's the pain mask they would give to her. That's how it started out.
Damn, what the hell?
Dilatus. That's how I started out.
That's what your girl married that said she was on.
Yeah, that's what they said Prince was using. That's one of the drugs they said Prince was using. But I think, personally, I don't believe that.
That's a lie.
I don't believe
Why would
that.
A drug dealer come out on that day saying, he get brought up on charges?
But Israel is stupid.
But they stupid, but I don't believe that. That's a lie. That's just very convenient that he came out that quick.
Plus, Prince was a health freak, man.
Yeah.
He was a health freak. I can't imagine him doing that, getting high. This man did concerts. He was on stage literally for hours just bouncing and dancing the whole time.
And they try to say he took drugs, he had stage fright.
Is that an Edomite or what? What's up, bro? What's up, bud?
Did you get my text earlier? I didn't know it, because by the time I didn't hear back from you, so I just had to leave.
You want to check over the camera? You made it, bro. Driven by the spirit.
And he's talking about your boy Prince.
Big old faggot.
They murdered him.
Right. Yeah, they killed him. Because he was already paranoid anyway, especially 2 years ago when he came out speaking about the system and
the chemtrail.
He went deeper than that, though.
Yeah.
He went deeper than that, talking about the Jews, how they was taking his money, man, taking his, you know,
that's
taking
why he refused
money.
To release all of his music.
Yeah. That's why he kept people around him. He didn't feel safe, man.
And his last post on Instagram was just when you thought you were safe.
That's what we thought you were safe. He probably knew they was coming. They probably told him. They probably told him. Man, that's some shit, man. It's gonna open up. We're gonna find out what's really going on behind the scene, man. That's what I can't wait to see, man.
I Googled that one day.
Somebody gonna actually have that, you know, if they ain't got no goddamn sense now, but these rich people, man, the entertainers and athletes and whatever, if they had sense, they would at least, if they had a conscience, they would at least start putting cameras on them. I wanna see what's going on, man.
Well, like Eddie Griffin said that he went back in the elite party in Hollywood. He said in one room, you motherfuckers.
Cat Williams. Yeah, right.
He's great. Oh, you see, he got beat up by a little boy.
Yeah. They said they fucking with him, man.
Yeah, he got.
I want to see what's going on behind the scenes for that to happen, man.
Yeah.
You know? Because it's some wicked shit. And Israel always down to do wicked shit for a few dollars, man. Always. But that's what I want to see. I want to see a rat Jew come up, you know, probably the head beast probably come visit these people and tell them, hey, we, you know, you sold your soul, right? We coming to collect it tomorrow, so.
Man, I heard, who was it, man? I forget what heavy metal group, but they said they was up in the studio recording the album, and out of nowhere, a bunch of rabbis come in, and then they start collecting, you know what I mean? Getting their money. They said it was actually the rabbis that was running the music studio.
That's right. Oh yeah, that's in that book Ford, man. He talks about, he goes through how they, how he just names everything, how what the Jews control. And he was going back then, and it pretty much covered everything anyway.
That's why you don't never see any musicians talking bad about those fake Jews.
That's right.
They ain't gonna say nothing about it.
They're not saying nothing against them. Well, you know they ain't gonna say nothing. Now, they killed Prince? Oh, I definitely ain't saying nothing.
Right, they made an example out of it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That put everybody else in check. Sure, they're like, I could be next.
Hopefully, but, you know, Lord gonna do something to make these motherfuckers be like, oh, I can't hold my mouth shut. Like, you know?
Yeah, because right.
This is the Lord's program.
We in the age of truth soon. Right. Yeah, you gonna have some martyrs.
I'm excited to see who's next, man.
Yeah, that's why I couldn't. I didn't know Prince was next.
Yeah, I didn't know.
That was a big one right there. Yeah. We knew somebody was coming. The next one.
That still got me kind of like wild.
That's a big one right
there.
Never
saw it coming.
Nah, Kevin Hart, he too. Unfortunately, the Most High gonna preserve him for the missiles, bro.
I've seen the meme.
He's all the way sold out.
The meme the day Prince died, it came on Facebook. It was like, more sad news in the music industry today. Kanye West was found alive in his apartment.
Yeah, because you know he sold out.
Yeah, he's going to continue to sell out.
Because he wearing the Baphomet shirts and everything.
Yeah, he's going to continue to.
He's a straight up devil worshiper.
With no conscience.
Yeah, he's open with it. He's open with it.
Yep. With no conscience whatsoever.
He openly worships the devil.
Oh, Jay-Z. It's wicked amongst Israel that's just like the depths of hell, man. Wicked amongst Israel.
That bring it out.
This is Ecclesiastes 8:8. There is no man that hath power over the spirit to retain the spirit. Neither hath power over the spirit to retain the spirit. Neither hath he power in the day of death. And there is no discharge in that war. Neither shall wickedness deliver those that are given to it.
Ooh, that's some covenants they make with them. You know, that's a covenant they make with death, man. They make a death with them. They think they're going to profit from it. They think their children they're going to bring in the world going to profit from it. And it's going to continue on. Their wicked ass, their wicked seed. Money, man. Money. With a goddamn bunch of Edomites on it. These people, our people are killing each other over.
Oh,
our people are flipped out of their goddamn minds over some FRN, some paper.
Yeah, paper is not money. It's
don't you wipe your ass with paper?
Yep, and you flush it down the toilet.
Right.
The real money, according to the Bible, was, well, first of all, real money is the word. But actually, when you're talking about physical money, what you use to, you know, purchase goods with, according to the Bible, is gold.
Right.
You know, okay, gold.
Our people are out of their wits over some paper. Some Federal Reserve notes.
What's that?
What about ones that don't read the Bible? What about people that don't even know?
You know what? The Bible
says.
That's
why we're out here.
Right.
I understand that, but how are you going to get them to listen?
Well, they don't listen. They're condemned already.
It ain't none of our concern.
Because, you know, don't you know, the majority of our people are going to die. The majority of our people are going to die.
If somebody don't know the Lord.
We're giving it to them. That's why we're out here.
That's why we out here.
That's why we out here.
But once they reject the Lord, then the Lord rejects them.
You never stop. Where's that in the scriptures?
He won't reject you.
Where's that in the scriptures? Because that foolish bullshit ain't in the scriptures.
He don't care how bad you keep doing.
We just brought that out last week.
But he ain't
coming. 2 weeks ago.
He's always there with open arms. Wait.
2 or 3. Where is that at? You know where it is offhand?
Titus.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna get that, man.
Yeah, Titus.
That's just cut.
Yeah,
what the fuck
you're
saying?
Titus says otherwise. Titus 3.
Right.
Yeah.
That's that church old nigga talking. That's that hood church talk. Yeah, that's it.
Right.
That's that faggot shit.
The nigga church.
That's what Pastor Porkchop teaches. Why he himself don't believe in a single word of the Bible.
Right.
He's just getting paid.
I got it.
Because we believe in his word. That's why we're out here and everybody else is not.
That's why the monkey got on the bus.
Yeah,
I want to sit out here and argue with the word, man.
You know what I mean? Because we're the ones out here, but he's an expert.
Right.
So, we're not concerned with you.
Old fool.
We reiterate that fact. We don't care.
Right. Here you go. This is Titus 3:5. But avoid foolish questions and genealogies and contentions and strivings about the law, for they are unprofitable and vain. A man that is an heretic after the first and second admonition, reject.
That's what I said, because we told him, he was like, yeah, if they don't listen.
He said, you gotta keep going.
We're not concerned with them.
Right.
And why are we gonna waste our breath and time with somebody who we know is not gonna get it? You know what I mean? The scriptures say that if anybody comes bring another gospel doctrine, let him be accursed.
That's right.
Instead of wasting our time with a two-third jackass.
And that was a two-jerk jackass that old fool. A man that is an heretic after the first and second admonition, reject.
Right, that's why if I be on YouTube, you know, you got the scoffers and scorners on the comment boards. Back in, you know, 3 years ago, I would have debated with somebody for hours. But now, after, if they don't get it after a couple points I prove them wrong, I just ignore you, man. I ignore you. Right. Why should I waste my time with you?
Right.
If you can't get it, I got better shit to do with my time.
Damn right. There's other people that
there's other people, right.
Yep. Knowing that he that is such is subverted and sinneth, being condemned of himself. So now, nigga, you condemned. Oh, fucking faggot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. Mind
blown. Hear what he said, man. You keep giving it to him.
That's the key word,
you keep giving it to him.
Yeah, let's see what the red letter said. We're going to get those red letters.
Oh, wait. Oh, here.
I'll go ahead. I got a powerful scripture. Go ahead.
Luke 10:10. But to whatsoever city you enter and they receive you not, go your ways out into the streets of the same and say, even the very dust of your city which cleaveth on us, we do wipe off against you. Notwithstanding, be sure of this, that the kingdom of God is come nigh unto you. But I say unto you, that it shall be more tolerable in the day of Sodom than for that city.
Said go to the city.
You gotta wipe the dust off your feet.
That's right.
That's like begging if you keep coming back. Like, hey, please yeah, speak the truth. Like begging.
If somebody don't get it, fuck him, man. We're not worried about you.
You know, that's who opened his mouth and condemned himself, man.
Like, we got unlimited time. The scripture said time is short. We got unlimited time to try to wake up two-thirds.
That's right.
Two-thirds ain't going to wake up.
Yeah, Esau even knows his time is short.
Yeah, time is short. We got time to be fucking with you, dumbasses. Look, John 3 and 18. This is a cold cut to that fool that came up here. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of the Most High.
Condemned,
I mean,
already.
You don't get no more clear than that.
Hey, bro, hey.
It said he that believeth not is condemned. So, but he's got open arms, though, right?
You're right, 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 right.
People are crazy, man.
Here you go. Oh, wicked ass nigga, man.
Satan got open arms for you.
Yeah, yeah. Sure the fuck
do. Satan always accepts you. Like we say,
Satan's willing to accept your doctrines too.
Yeah, see, Satan accepts everything except for the truth.
That's right.
You can be a transgender. You know what I'm saying? You can be Muslim, Hindu. Those are all different forms of Satanism.
Here you go. This is Matthew 13:6. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For verily, I say unto you, that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which ye see, and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear, and have not heard them. Hear ye therefore the parable of the sower. When anyone heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which receives seed by the wayside.
That was funny though, how your boy, he was talking that madness. Then we tried to give him the truth. He didn't receive it, then his ass got carried away.
That's right.
Where'd he go?
Yep.
Look, is he over there? He ain't over there. He's not over there.
That's right.
He, your boy, got carried away.
He's out of there. You know? It's funny, though.
It is funny.
But he that was, okay, yet hath he not root in himself, but doeth for a while. For when tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, by and by he is offended.
Yeah, because people, they get offended by the word.
He also that receives seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word, and the care of this world, and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful.
Hey, we was just talking about those riches.
The spirit took us back.
That's how it is. That's how it always is. Always do that.
Yep. But he that receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some an hundredfold and some 60, some 30. Another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemies came and sowed tares among the wheat, and went his way. That's it. It's going to
somewhere. So that's a cold cut to your boy. I mean, he didn't even stick around to even get the full cut. He got cut enough.
Yeah, he said something, came over there, he went over there and hid.
Yeah, he ran. He
snuck on the bus.
Yeah, you know, it's like throwing a rock at somebody and running.
Like some bitch. See all the razor bumps he had from shaving?
Yeah.
All the razor bumps he had. Probably wake up every day with blood and pus leaking out of him and shit.
Yeah, that's
scratching.
Gross, man.
Nasty motherfucker.
Yeah, you get them, you shave like that, you get those ingrown hairs.
My son and my brother got all that shit.
Yeah, why you think the scriptures say don't shave, man? That's just, should be common sense shit. You shave, you taking a razor to your head, the top of your head, or your beard, or anywhere, you're going to get those ingrown hairs.
They're in the grace, though, in their mind. They're in the grace. They can do what the fuck they want. Yeah. And that's their attitude. They think they can do what the fuck they want.
Yeah, because back when I used to shave, yeah, you'd be all miserable. You get shaved, and my neck just blood everywhere.
Oh, God.
Why would you do that to yourself? Blood everywhere, then you try to wipe it off and shit start burning.
So you get gigantic band-aids on your head from shaving and shit. Walking around with band-aids on your head. Wicked Israel. Ain't nothing worse than Israelite, man.
Yeah, because I feel like a beast with my beard, man. You know what I mean? You feel like a lion.
It feels good.
Yeah.
Choking this shit.
You know what I mean? Because you feel like a real man when you start, you know, you doing what the Lord said to do. Like, you don't eat pork. The scriptures say don't eat pork, man. You'll feel a lot healthier. You know, you got, you eating all that pork every day, it's clogging your insides up. Your body can't digest it properly. Shit gives you high blood pressure.
No more visit to the doctor.
Yeah, you ain't gonna. Right. And these people wonder why they're in such bad health.
No answers, huh? No answers, man. But they go to Esau, though, the physician. Here, just take this. It may have 20, 30 side effects, but here, take this. It's gonna make you all better.
They said the hospitals are the leading causes of death in America.
Bro, I know that's wrong.
People come, they go into the hospital with just, you know, they might have like a broken bone. They come out with all kind of diseases.
Won't come out at all.
Or won't come out at all. Like my grandma, she went and got surgery, and they left like a little pin or something up inside of her body.
Ooh,
and she had pains and aches in that spot for years and years.
Wow.
Until she finally found out they had
left something
in there. And they did, yeah, they do that on purpose. You think, oh, it was just an accident. No, they don't accident. These people are evil, man. We talking about Esau.
That's how my dad's mom was. She went to the hospital sick. And 2 days later, 3 days later, she was dead. They
Damn.
Said the cancer just, they probably punched or something. Because cancer, usually, it can, your body isolates it. They probably poked it on purpose. And it spread over a complete body.
Then they'll make you go through that chemotherapy.
Just like that. Oh, shit. She ain't got time to do all that.
Well, you see people
right
go
away.
To chemotherapy, they get all fucked up
yep,
from that.
Hair falling
all out. That radiation.
Yep. Become sterile and shit from all that radiation. You know? Eazy-E went to the doctor. Remember he went in?
Oh, he went to the hospital and never came out.
Came out, yeah. Eazy-E, the same day, the very next day, he dropped dead.
Yeah, they say, you know, people, most diseases can be cured just by your diet. What'd your boy Hippocrates say, you know, from the Hippocratic Oath? How do you say his name? Hippocrates or Hippocrates? Whatever his name is. But he had this old saying that said, let thy food be the medicine and your medicine thy food. Because real medicine is a food. Just eat right, man. And chances are you ain't gonna get sick. Don't be putting a bunch of bullshit in your body, man. Eating pork. That shit got so much damn grease in it.
All the mac worms and shit.
I told you the pork is so greasy. Back in that, they used to use pork grease in warfare. Like the Mongols, you know, like Genghis Khan and them. The Mongols, you know how you ever see those giant catapults they use? They shoot them flaming balls at people.
Oh yeah.
How they got those balls flaming like that?
Right.
They would use pork fat.
Pork fat.
Because it would burn hotter than anything else.
That's crazy.
And just slop it up with some pork grease and launch it at your ass.
Here's a hypocritical book.
Oh, yeah. Well, he had, It's not the oath, it's a saying he had. Right. It might be under, I don't know. You probably just Google, let thy medicine be thy food, and thy food thy medicine. Yeah, even though he was a pagan, though, but he got that one thing right. You know, he had enough sense to know that eating healthy is going to make you healthy, obviously.
Yeah, but back then it wasn't like now.
Even like most people, what's the most popular food is pizza's got pork on it. And if they're not eating pork, they're eating, you know, the hamburger's real popular. That's all fat. Yeah, actually, most hamburgers probably is not even made out of burgers. You don't know. That's the mystery meat. You go into these restaurants, these fast food restaurants. Yeah, oh, I remember the last time I ate a taco from Taco Bell. That ground beef in them tacos, that does not look like the ground beef you get from the supermarket. And something ain't right with that shit, man.
Tell me to eat chips, my stomach start hurting.
Chips?
Yeah.
Yeah, chips. Yeah, so there's oils in it.
Sir. I can imagine what they put in that shit, man. I can fucking imagine.
Yeah, because you look on the back of the food package, it's like a science experiment. You can't even pronounce half the words on there.
Here you go. This is Ecclesiastes 38:1. Honor a physician with the honor due unto him for the use which he may have of him.
Oh, and physician, too. That's a good point, is that that's where you get the word physics, you know, the laws of physics, which means the laws of nature, because the word physician means the natural, somebody who deals with natural things, you know, herbs. Go ahead.
For the Lord hath created him, for the Most High cometh healing, and he shall receive honor of the king. The skill of the physician shall lift up his head, and in the sight of great man he shall be in admiration. The Lord have created medicines out of the earth, and he that is wise will not abhor them.
Yeah, you wise, you're going to use those medicines. Like garlic is a natural medicine. You get sick, you feel that cold coming on or whatever, start. Well, you should eat garlic anyway, but eat some whole garlic cloves. Mm-hmm. Yeah, them viruses do not like that garlic.
Yeah, they don't like honey.
They don't like honey.
You know, they don't like cinnamon. You know, they hate that shit, man.
Some ginger too.
Oh, look, I gotta tell you too, if you see my knuckles before, I was all ashy as fuck. I'm still a little bit, but I get real ashy, right? I get super ashy, so ashy my skin will start cracking. But I don't like using that lotion. It's all, you don't know what that lotion's made out of.
Oh, yeah, they put all kind of medicine in there too.
But yeah, because it's not good for your skin. I just put olive oil on my skin, man. It cures me right up.
Yeah.
I'll use olive oil for lotion. It's all natural, it's good for your skin.
I'm gonna get some shea butter.
That's some shea butter?
Yeah, they got natural shea butter.
Okay. Yeah, all that stuff.
Yeah, but they do use olive oil for skin. That's
it cured me because my knuckles were just straight cracked. Almost bleeding. They get
olive
so ashy.
Yeah. It's an oil, multi purpose oil.
Yeah. I use olive oil. You can use olive oil to make lamps out of it.
Right. Is that Tim Hortons open? I wonder if I'm gonna get some tissue.
I think it is open.
I think it's the pollen, man. Oh, shit, man. Got me.
Pollen fucks me up, too. I could barely even breathe last week.
Oof.
Or earlier this week. I can't remember.
Pollen, it's high, too. Pollen level's high. He sort of killed off all the fucking bees.
Plus
and
all
that's
the,
what bees do. They regulate that, you know, that pollen level.
Plus all that pollution, too, with the chemtrail. They've been spraying more chemtrail. Look, all these clouds up. Look at those clouds on camera.
That's fake clouds.
No, you can tell they're fake. Those were chemtrails, and they just spread apart. Those are all fake clouds. This should be a clear day today. Because remember they said, because even Alex Jones was talking about it. He's like, did the chemtrail flu kill, I don't know if that's what it was. That seems a little out there. But there is cases of, and they said they was putting the flu and shit. They spraying us with all kind of diseases.
Breathing that shit in, man. Can never be good over time.
And you don't know what's in that drinking water either. You know, they already know. Need to put fluoride in the water.
Hey, Granville, I told y'all, man, that shit's everywhere, man. But now it's coming out that Granville, where Esau is, Granville.
Granview?
Granview.
Yeah.
It's the water, they find lead in the water.
Oh, talking about the water up in Detroit. Well, not Detroit, the Flint, Michigan, right? How they had that water.
Right.
All the water was polluted. Now all kind of people that was behind it are dropping dead. The head of the water plant was found murdered.
What?
One of the top,
they killed him.
One of the top protesters, the woman who sued the city, they found her ass dead.
Yeah.
I think it was like three people dead already.
Yeah, before they talk, they got it.
Because they say they was purposely poisoning the water in the black neighborhoods.
Yeah, that's everywhere. That's everywhere. He's only giving one black community water and another one.
But their water was like straight up yellow. Yeah,
right. That shit probably caught on fire, I think.
Oh, no, I heard about that. Somewhere. Yeah, that was here in Columbus once. Wow. They said the water was catching on fire.
That's crazy, man. Put a flame to it, the water actually catch on fire, man. Esau. God damn, man.
And if you want to get any good water, you got to pay for it. What kind of shit is that? Water, the most abundant resource on earth, you gotta pay for it.
They went to some mountains. Edomite did a study at chemtrails. They went to some mountains where people don't go. They went somewhere where they don't go, found some ponds, and tested the water. And the water was full of that shit. The water was full of it. Just they went to somewhere where no one goes.
It way up in some mountains,
and it was polluted, man. They tested different ponds, and the water had all kind of burial and all that other shit that's in those chemtrails in it, man.
Because Esau's got to have all this shit.
It was heavily concentrated, too, man. Heavily concentrated. This devil ain't playing, man. This devil went in overtime to get rid of the children of Israel, man. He went that birthright back.
He hates nature, too.
Yeah. Hates his mom.
That's why Esau reminds me of them. If you watch Lord of the Rings, man, he reminds me of the Saruman and the orcs. How they just... All they care. You gotta watch it, because it shows you perfectly.
Because
all they cared about with Saruman, Creole, and the orcs, all they care about is warfare, killing, chopping the whole. They were chopping down all the trees just to build instruments of war.
That's madness.
Just raping the entire earth.
That's madness. Here you go.
Really, Esau's like an orc, you know, like a goblin, a troll.
Yeah. It's the cancer. Was not the water made sweet with wood, that the virtue thereof might be known? And he hath given men skill, that he might be honored in his marvelous works. With such doth he heal men, and taketh away their pains. Of such doth the apothecary make a confection, and of his works there is no end. And from him is peace over all the earth. My son, in thy sickness be not negligent, but pray unto the Lord, and he will make thee whole. Leave off from sin, and order thine hands aright, and cleanse thy heart from all wickedness. Give a sweet savior and a memorial of fine flour, and make a fat offering as not being. Then give place to the physician, for the Lord hath created him. Let him not go from thee, for thou hast need of him. There is a time when in their hands there is good success, for they shall also pray unto the Lord, that he will prosper that which they give for ease and remedy to prolong life. He that sinneth before his maker, let him fall into the hand of the physician. Dr. Frankenstein.
But nowadays, if you talk about natural cures or remedies, people, even, you know, there are people that say, that's bullshit. You better go to a doctor. I'm talking that bullshit.
I'm going to
ain't no doctor. You don't know what you're talking about. These people are dumb, man. They just need pushed down a flight of steps.
Yeah. Take them right up there and drop off like ISIS is doing.
Yeah, like
when they be finding faggots and
they
shit.
They just throw them off the roof.
Yeah, they go to the highest building around too.
Let me get that scripture, bro. In the scripture, they said, King David was throwing Edomites off the cliff.
Well, that was
Joab.
Nah.
I'm a find it.
Yeah, find it though. That was
second. Is it Kings or Chronicles?
Yeah.
I just do a search on Cliff.
That was I can't remember. I feel super long.
Oh man.
Cause that's bad though. That is bad, man.
No, it's in the Book of Chronicles. It's dealing with King David. Oh man. See, I'm slagging.
Slipping?
Yeah. That's not good. I'm
fine. Ecclesiasticus 18 and 19. Learn before thou speak, and use physic, or ever thou be sick.
Yeah, not no medicine from storage.
Maybe it's like mounts.
Right, a prescription of hey, there's so many prescriptions they give you, man. And like I said, they always mention after the commercial the side effects of taking these drugs, man. Blindness, whatever it is, man. Shit like for high blood pressure,
I mean, it makes your pancreas go bad. It kills your liver. I mean, the list goes on and on, man. And how many Israelites are on high blood pressure medicine, man? And they still on that high blood pressure medicine. They still smoke weed. They still smoking packs and packs of Newports.
Well, they think that medicine going to offset it.
Right, right, right. And it,
The cigarette's medicine is pure poison, man.
You ain't lying. A cigarette mixed with a bad diet?
That shit's unnatural as hell. Look at the filter. Got fiberglass, man. Out of fiberglass. Yeah.
So you can simply sit out in the sun and get, you know, vitamin D. Skin.
Yep. Deep in the skin. Well, you can catch a buzz just off of sunlight.
That vitamin D helps your pineal gland.
Yeah. That you start. You know, you get natural highs. You be high on life.
What's this? Yeah. The prophecy. We're out here prophesying. Huh? We're out here prophesying the destruction of this world. The destruction of this world.
The Lord's about to bring America, that fire.
America is about to burn from the East Coast to the West Coast, from up north to down south by thermonuclear missiles. And this was prophesied in the Bible.
It's going to be beautiful.
What are you, an Elam, Mike? You Elam? You know Elam?
Get Isaiah 50,
you know what Elam is?
Are
you East Indian?
No.
What's your nationality? You're from Africa? Where are you from in Africa? Ethiopia?
Yeah.
Okay. We can tell he's Ethiopian.
I see him with the same spirit.
Yeah.
No.
There's a lot of Jake scattered over there.
Oh, yeah. But you know
Isaiah
what the Israelites?
Isaiah 66 and 15.
Yeah.
You know, the Israel people over there in Israel ain't the true Israelites. The people of the Negroes here in America are the Israelites. The true Israelites.
Hey, he got a scripture for you.
We're the people of the Lord.
Isaiah 66 and 15.
That's why we're looked down upon. That's why we're shunned on. They see us, people like want to go the other way. That's how you know we're the Lord's people. What y'all got?
Isaiah 66 and 15. For behold, Yahweh will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flame of fire.
You see that? He said the Lord is coming with fire. To burn this wicked ass sinful kingdom. Excuse my French, but this place is out of here. This fucking place is no good air. This is a cesspool of vomit and diarrhea. You know? Getting abortion is these women are so foul, they go out, run the streets, get drunk, and go home, go in the prescription cabinet, and it's called a day after pill or something like that. It's a pill they take to abort the baby from them going out screwing 50 men that night. This is America. America look upon this and encourage it more and more in the women. And then they got the women, the men marrying men, the women marrying women. Now they starting to marrying their horses and their dogs. This is America we talking about. And with
nobody your money, nobody your money, dog.
You ain't gonna marry your dog. At least I hope not.
No.
And check it out. Now let's look at how this place was. Let's look at how this filthy nation was started. It started by the enslavement of the children of Israel, by bloodshed. You know, they killed off the Native American Indians. That's totally made all kind of fake, false treaties. They wrote a bunch of false treaties just simply to deceive the Native Americans. All they did was sign the treaties and came and just slaughtered them by. You know, the men used to go out hunting, and that's what they did. All the men would go out hunting at one time. And Esau knew this because he observed their ways. And when the men went out hunting, then they go slaughter the reservations or whatever you want to call it, where the Israelites were.
I see you guys.
Okay. Yeah. This devil is evil, man. He's fucking evil as all fucking hell, man. I'm still trying to get that book, The Trail of Tears, man.
Hey, Trail of Tears, Andrew Jackson was the president. Was behind the Trail of Tears. Now everybody's in an uproar because they're gonna take Andrew Jackson.
Oh, yeah. And put that black bitch on.
They're gonna put Harriet Tubman on there.
A black bitch, Harriet Tubman. They plan on putting on $20 bill for her, or they plan on making a new $25 bill.
Now they said it's gonna be the 20.
Yeah, because they're talking about the new $25.
They're doing that on purpose through the Cosmore Division.
Hillary, wasn't that Harriet Tubman was not for our people? And that's what they got our people thinking, that Harriet Tubman was for our people.
Because the slaves were never freed. Because to be freed, if the slaves were freed, then Abraham Lincoln would have given the Liberation Proclamation. To liberate means to free.
We were emancipated.
They were emancipated. Every time in history slaves were freed, they always called it a liberation of the slaves.
Right.
But all of a sudden, they use this word emancipate, which nobody knows what that means.
Never looked it up.
It's a Latin word, And emancipate means to transfer ownership from one to another. That's literally what it means.
There's a new $20 bill.
Oh, wow.
What is that?
Ric Flair on the motherfucker.
Ric Flair. Hey, that's an Israelite for your ass right there. Ric
fucking Flair.
Woo!
That's a wicked son of a bitch.
Yeah, that's a wicked motherfucker, bro.
Right. And it's known he a wicked son of a bitch.
Oh, he'd tell you.
Yeah, yeah.
He'd tell you, bro.
That's an adulterous man.
He was like, with my $500 shirt.
Yeah, he always, yeah, Ric Flair always bragged about money, but that's why he's one of the brokest wrestlers of them all.
Yeah.
Always in finance, because he sniffed it all up his nose.
You know a key word, which one?
I can't find, I've been looking up mount, I'm looking up through now.
Probably just look up on Google. I bet you they got it.
I don't have no internet. Yeah.
You want to look it up? Or you want to lose my tab? If you can, if you want. Yeah.
Password. I know, man. It's been a minute since I read that one. Cause I know where the one is. It's not the same chapter where, let me look up. Maybe it's in the same chapter as when it's smitten every male in Edom. I don't know if that's in the same chapter or not.
Yeah.
See, we can get a picture too.
Because I remember back about 5 years ago, we used to talk about that scripture a lot.
Because I actually found a picture of the mountain where they did it.
Yeah, I actually found a picture of somebody drawing it, of them doing it.
That's awesome.
You know, I used to collect all kind of pictures, man, that people post online. That's reminiscent that you know, that goes back to the scriptures.
My shit just crashed on me.
2 Chronicles 15.
You serious?
Oh, you got it that quick.
Wow,
see?
Wow.
I said I was close.
Hey, I told you, technology is meant for us to have.
It really is.
And if they don't, you know, we ain't watching, we ain't got these technologies to be looking at no PCI porn in these motherfuckers. You know? That's more proof that it's for us to use, man. Here we look for
2 Chronicles 15?
I got to look at it in my damn system, so I'm going to lose it.
15 is 12.
You sure that's it? That's not right. There's a 1 Chronicles.
Yeah, 2 Chronicles 25.
Oh, about to say.
Reading of 2 Chronicles
25 and 12.
Oh, I got it. I wanted to read this one.
Yeah, I got to look so I can remember what
it
is. Get the picture of the mountain. Man, look at that. That looks like scariest foot. Jump off.
Amaziah.
Oh, see if we can get that on
camera. The name is Amaziah.
Probably not going to show up. You probably have to turn the brightness up or something. Just get on Google and look up, you know, just do a search on it. You'll find that cliff. That's a high cliff too, man. And that's on just, that's not a... That's rough. You hit, it looks like the rocks are sharp.
You gone.
So.
Yeah, look at the movie Apocalypto when the wicked Israelite cut his brother off the chain, the rope, when they was towing him somewhere, and they was on the side of a mountain, and one of them was holding him up because he was injured. He cut him off, and they watched him fall down the mountain. He was hitting the rocks, and you know, oh man, look, that's a horrible way to die, man. And when somebody throw you off a mountain, that means they got real hatred for your ass. Yeah, Amaziah.
It's Amaziah. It's not David.
Right.
Well, I was thinking King David before. I'm way off.
Well, King David probably did some lot.
I was thinking that's when King David smitten every male in Edom.
Right. Yeah. Right. You know, like you said, he was doing, doing the same shit.
It's just a whole family tradition. Well, is that Hank Williams song? It's a family tradition.
Right. Right. That's funny.
Yeah, Amaziah.
That's funny.
Now, let's read it. This is 2 Chronicles 25 and 11. And Amaziah strengthened himself and led forth his people and went to the Valley of Salt. Well, that's probably over there by the Dead Sea. Oh, yeah, because Esau lived right by the Dead Sea. That didn't even grow over there. And went to the Valley of Salt and smote the children of Seir 10,000. Dang, he killed 10,000 Edomites. Because Mount Seir, that's the home of Esau. And other 10,000 left alive did the children of Judah carry away captive and brought them unto the top of the rock and cast them down from the top of the rock that they all were broken in pieces. That's hilarious.
Hey, that's Esau
future. So that's a total of 20,000 Edomites they killed. 20,000. They just tossing them off the... You know they was having fun, too, probably.
Yeah, drinking that good wine.
Yeah, drinking while they was doing it, have contests so you could throw them the farthest. I mean, that's all. How long would it take to throw 10,000 Edomites off a cliff?
They weren't in a hurry.
They was having fun with it. Just
probably
think about
made
it.
A game. Let's see you could get it on the target.
Yeah, that's probably... You see that rock right there? I'm going to get it. You know what I mean?
Make them bets.
Yeah, make them... You're right. They was making wagers. You can always see that. That's how Jake do it. Jake likes to make a wager out of everything. Everything's a contest. You know what I mean? That's just that's our spirit that's in us. You know what I mean? We like we're competitive by nature.
Most of Israel is just wicked as hell, just want to be better.
Oh yeah, they that's
they probably
thing.
Had it like a curveball. Or a knuckleball. Yeah, like they like let's see who could get it to stay still while it's falling.
Or say how many rotations you can get on it on the way down. You know, the loudest screams on the way down. See who can get him to scream the loudest. That's in the Bible though. We're not making that up. That's right there in 2 Chronicles.
I support y'all. Don't read that one.
Yeah. Oh, never.
So it's all about love.
Because according to the church, Esau can be saved. Yeah. But that's a lie.
That's
some
blasphemous shit to be saying.
Yeah, that is blasphemy.
Isaiah 33 and 18. Thine heart shall meditate terror. Where is the scribe? Where is the receiver? Where is the accountant of the towers? I'm just going to read that again. Isaiah 33 and 18. Thine heart shall meditate terror. That's the only part right there.
Yeah, because just like the other scripture, when it said, the Lord said that Israel is his battle axe and weapons of war. You know? Oh, I got to get Psalms 44. Guess all that's the spirit. Read Psalms 44. It goes in on it.
Oh shit.
Why do you think they call the Lord of Sabaoth? The Lord of the armies. Go ahead. Or they always call the Lord of hosts. It means the Lord of the armies. Go ahead. The Lord of hosts. The Lord in Matthew 10 and 34, the one they call Jesus. Well, by the way, his real name is not Jesus. It's Yahweh Shai, okay? Yahweh Shai said, think not that I come to bring peace upon earth. I come not to send peace, but a sword. That's right there in the scriptures.
Man, that's a hell of a
it's in the scriptures, not in the churches, okay? Because you ain't going to find a Lord in the church.
Sure.
The real church is right here. The real church is your body and your mind. Your mind is your temple. Go ahead.
Temple.
That's why they write on your forehead, what they call it, on the side of your head, that's called your temple right there. Because that's the temple is right there in your mind, that's your right. spirit.
Let me read this real quick, Exodus 15 and 3. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name.
That's right. That's the Lord's a man of war. That's why the Bible is a manly book too. So, you know, like little feminine weaklings, this ain't going to mesh too well with their spirit.
Yeah, that's
the Bible, you know, is for men. It's like a manly book.
Here you go, Revelation 19 and 11. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat upon him was called faithful and true. And in righteousness he doth judge and make war.
And make war. We descend from a long line of warriors, you know what I mean, kings and priests. Hey, go ahead. Get that Psalms 44 and 1.
Psalms 44 and 1. We have heard with our ears, O God, our fathers have told us what work thou didst in their days, in the times of old. How thou didst drive out the heathen with thy hand and plentest them. How thou didst afflict the people and cast them out. For they got not the land in possession by their own sword, neither their own arm.
Hold on a second. Hey, go ahead. It's too loud, man. Yeah, that's in the scriptures too.
Yeah.
Marcus for the dead.
Neither did their own arm save them, but thy right hand and thine arm in the light of thy countenance, because thou hast a favor unto them.
Yeah, right. So if you go into battle and the Lord ain't with you, you ain't gonna win. You're gonna get slaughtered. You're gonna die. And everybody that's with you is all gonna perish. Yep. But if the Lord is with you, you're gonna be victorious. Keep going.
Thou art my king, O God. Command deliverance unto Jacob. Through thee will I push down our enemies. Through thy name will I tread them under that raise up against us.
See, that's what we just talking about. The Lord's a man of war. Okay, so the Bible is a manly book. Okay, go ahead.
For I will not trust in my bow, neither shall my sword save me. But thou hast saved us from our enemies and hast put them to shame that hated us.
So the Lord has enemies, okay? Because the Lord don't love everybody. Jesus don't love everybody.
I got a description.
Oh, go ahead.
It's just proof that the Lord got to be with you.
All right.
Okay, this is Joshua. Where am I at?
John sees just a terrorist.
Huh?
John sees a terrorist.
Yeah, they're so-called Jews.
Jews run this government. They are terrorists. They terrorize the people.
Yeah, you're right. They
the whole
are.
Earth. The whole
they're not even the real Jews. We're the real Jews. They're imposters. They lie. They
try to see the shit. They act like the public. They treat people like shit in their homes.
Yeah. No, he's good.
You good.
He testified.
They'll make friends with people and set them up because they make money from the FCC.
Yeah.
And their families go to the school to be doctors and attorneys. And
They never did a day of hard work in their life.
Yeah.
They run this country locks like a bear.
And if they do something wrong, you try to talk to them about, well, so I'm helping you, you're going to jail. I got OCD. They're the kind of people who try to use their illnesses against people when,
Yeah, you on point, man.
It's true.
That's what they're supposed to do, though.
That's why the Bible calls them.
They use it as a tool. Sorry, people who really have illnesses and do things, but they use it, when they do something wrong or they think they have the right to violate people because they have money.
Yeah.
Well, they call all of us goyim and schleppers. They consider.
Yeah, I never paid much attention to this until I seen this. What religion is this?
It ain't no religion. It's the Bible. The Bible is a religious book.
That's why I don't really believe in any religion myself because none of them are perfect. I just believe in what's doing what's right.
Well, the Lord, the Lord was against a stat of religion.
Any religion is like a name for a group or
right,
a gang.
Well, man-made religion.
Schottenstein's is a cult. Make a cult.
See, with Jews, you lose.
Yeah, religion is actually a Latin word that goes back to the meaning to hold back.
I mean, look, they don't do nothing for Columbus. They try making things look good on the outside, but not on the inside.
Oh, yeah,
that's why they're on.
Right.
If you drink or you smoke weed, they won't do nothing. They're not. They used to. Oh, man.
How you go, bro? This is so brothers can learn the truth.
Yeah, don't put. He won't record you. He didn't know you didn't want to be
there. Ain't too many people gonna watch it no way. So.
Yeah, ain't nothing to be afraid of.
They're out to get me, man, really.
Well, they out to get all of us.
Yeah.
If you're an Israelite, they out to get you.
No, personally.
Yeah. Well, I ran into a dude at one of them Alex Jones dude. He said the government was chasing me one day.
Oh,
got away. I was like, really?
They get that paranoia in them.
Yeah.
Hey, the Lord is with you. You ain't got nothing to fear, bro. You know what I mean? Because they despise this Bible.
Yeah, they're trying to make me Jewish. They're trying to get me to work for them.
Jewish.
I won't side with them because of the way they do it. What I was saying, if they find out you drink or smoke, they'll make it an issue to get you into their system. Then they go around and try to rub in your face. But we're on drugs.
They'll
ask you to drink a shot, but then when you don't kiss their ass, it's a problem.
That's a wrap for you.
Yeah, because they look at you like you're just a slave. They're a slave.
Well, you know what? The Lord gave them this world to rule for a certain amount of time. So they're supposed to act like devils. They're supposed to oppress under them.
Right now, we're in punishment right now.
Right. They're only doing what they're supposed to do. Now, if you were given power, you're going to do the same thing. You're gonna abuse that power to a certain extent.
What they're doing is they're getting everybody on disability and Social Security, making them feel like they're helping make money.
Right.
If they did it that way, if they put it in that way, they would have so much money, and then people would have the ability to make more money. But it's all about keeping people, making people.
Well, when it goes back to money, who owns all the banks? The so-called Jews. The Jews, they own all the banks. They print the money. The Federal Reserve knows you got in your pocket. Those fake Jews, they print that money.
I read the Bible once, but
check this out. Reach Mike in Revelation 2.
I was friends with Louis Schatz. He acts like his best friends. I had money in my IRA. I told him I was going to take the money out to get a car. Next thing I know, it gets closed because I owe a debt.
Woo! Woo! Hey, they about to start arresting people if you're in debt to banks or whatever. They're going to actually come and come knocking on doors,
Yeah, they go to debtor's prison.
Yeah, because this is when the chip is going to come in. Because they're going, this is your way out. Get the chip, get the RFID chip, and we're going to let you out of jail. But this is what's coming in the near future, that RFID chip.
What do you think about Bruce Jenner?
Bruce Jenner need to be thrown in a pot of burning oil.
Yeah, that's why he's like this.
Right.
Because it's a crime.
Right.
They're telling him, you do this, or you're going to...
Well, Bruce Jenner is actually an Edomite, though. He's not an Israelite.
Yeah.
So he's a natural homosexual anyway. He's an actual Edomite.
Actually, not.
You know?
He was.
You know what an Edomite is?
I read the Bible, but I'm not in detail.
Well, we're here to tell you all that, though. Yeah. We're here to answer all that.
Those Jews, those we don't want to leave they're not Jews. They're actually
Edomites. My mother
Edomites.
Was Buddhist. My father's bad.
Hey, read it. Let me read this to you real quick.
An Edomite.
I just blew.
That's a so-called white man.
Look at it. Let me read this for you. Look.
That's his biblical name.
This is out.
Edom.
This is out the Jewish Encyclopedia. These Jews wrote this themselves in their own book. It says Edom is modern Jewry. Okay, now read this one. This is out of the Jewish Almanac, compiled by Jews, right? It says, strictly speaking, it is incorrect to call an ancient Israelite a Jew or to call a contemporary, which means modern, Jew an Israelite or a Hebrew.
Wow.
So they know they're not Israelites. They know they're the children of Satan.
Look at this.
Oh, that's a boy.
Who?
Yeah, I'm getting that. I was getting sidetracked. Your boy came at the right time, though.
So the truth is getting out on these devils, though, you know?
Devils, that's right.
Devils, that's what
they are. Hey, did you read Revelation yet?
It's Revelation 2 and 9. I know thy works, the tribulation and problems, thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
You hear this,
man?
You hear this? The blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
Oh, the definition.
Yeah,
oh, okay. I thought you meant look at the words. Yeah. All right. Yeah, let me get my dictionary. Go ahead.
And are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
That motherfucker. Blood shot scenes are perfect example of what I'm saying. They abuse their money. They think they have the right to buy the web.
Well, they own this country.
They own the world.
Do you know even the slave trade? Did they own all the slave ships? They was behind the whole slave trade in America.
The whole goddamn thing. Right, you know, every war is a banking war, and they own the banks.
Right, the Civil War in America, both sides, the North and the South, was funded by the so-called Jews.
The same people.
Both sides. Because they're the master manipulators.
That's crazy, man.
They're the masters of manipulation. Yeah. They're the puppet masters.
The puppet masters.
And nobody knows it, you know, because they're real slick. Because the Satan is, that's why the scripture
says. They even try to turn my own mother against me. You know,
yeah,
family.
That's what they do. They're good at that. Family.
I was brought from Vietnam, and they're trying to keep me away from, they're trying to keep me here to make the money as a way of suffering.
Use a name?
I was born, man.
Okay. Oh, your dad was in the military?
Born in 68.
Your dad was military?
Is your mom Vietnamese?
Yeah.
Okay. I can kind of tell
you something. You my age.
Oh, yeah. What kind of tank you got?
This is a Hercules V2.
Yeah, I got a Cyclone. It works good. I got the...
This is...
I got the Cyclone. It has really good flavor, but it leaks. So I got this...
This is the best one.
Hey, let me get... Don't worry about that. We ain't talking about that. Let's get a... I got a definition.
Yeah, it's probably good, but I was looking for one that's bigger. Trying to get like 5 to 7 bass.
Stay focused.
Yeah, it's all right.
Listen... Because like he said, that these are the counterfeit Jews, right? And here's the definition of counterfeit. It's to make a copy of, usually with the intent to defraud, to make a pretense, feign, to carry on a deception, dissemble, to make imitations.
Make imitations.
Made an imitation of what is genuine with the intent to defraud.
That's bad.
Circumcision.
That's bad.
Go ahead.
It's wisdom of Solomon 2:16. We are esteemed of him as counterfeits. He abstained from our ways as from filthiness. He pronounces the end of the just to be blessed, and he maketh his boast that God is his father. That's the Edomites talking about the elect. Well, hopefully it's us, but calling them counterfeits because they're copies. They're not real Jews.
Yeah, they're fake.
So what is, I see you guys, people like you standing around all the time, but
right.
What is the general purpose?
To teach the gospel to all nations, to wake up Israel.
We're prophesying. That's what we're doing. You know what, the truth? Men out here are prophesying. The other ones, they just doing something else. You ever seen the ones in the red down here?
Well, they got a purple. There's a purple.
I've seen ones in white. And like
purple and
colors.
Red, white.
One of them purple ones just walked by. Where'd he go? He's seen us and got
so
scared.
Are you guys the same group or are they different? Groups?
Nah, they.
And we're supposed to be brothers.
We the only
That's
one.
Just proof, you know? That's
they,
just proof.
They don't want to get caught out there.
Right, right.
Because they will get. Because
that's proof.
They don't know what they're talking about.
That's proof.
He's messing with somebody's weak right now.
messing with a non-believer.
Well, that's gonna, that blood is going to be on his hands.
See?
That blood is going to be on his hands.
They're saying on the news, you know, their kids are some of the biggest drug users. They don't want us to enjoy marijuana. The only way they want us to enjoy it is so they can make money and keep track of us.
Well, Matt,
while they're, you know, using it themselves. So I've cleaned for some.
Well, cannabis is supposed to be a medicine, you know?
Well, yeah.
So, but they don't want it to be legal. You know, they... All the medicines they give you in the hospitals will kill you.
Yeah.
I mean, Oxycontins are legal.
So Percocets.
Percocets are legal. I mean, all these things are highly addictive. They destroy families.
It's legal, right? Because there's drug corners.
There's drug stores on every corner.
And all you got to do is walk in there with a piece of paper and say, the doctor said I can have so many pills. And,
well, if you read like books like Death by Prescription, it tell you that medications, they used to take out the cofactors and trace minerals off foods.
Yeah, exactly. Right, because it... All the food, most of the, all this processed food they got in the stores, it has no minerals in it. Has no vitamins and nutrients in it.
They strip that shit.
They strip it. That's why you keep, you can eat.
Yeah, everything is they strip it to make money another way. They'll take it out so they can sell it separate to make more money.
You know what they be doing? They be like, they be saying good source of vitamin C. And they be like 10% of vitamin C. 10% out of 100.
Right. With high fructose corn syrup.
Yeah, like it makes no deal.
You probably don't even got that 10 either.
Nah. Plus, even to sell your food in the stores, you have to get you have to go through one of these Jewish kosher unions. Like, you ever hear of the Orthodox kosher union? It's like a, if you buy food from the store, it have a U with a circle around it. You ever see it on a food package? It's pretty, you probably find some of that trash right there. Just for an example, but you have to pay those fake Jews just to sell the food in the stores.
Yeah, they charge a lot more money for the good food.
Yeah.
And then the stuff that...
Yeah, right.
Yeah, you've been to the Jewish Kroger in Bexley? Right there in, not Bexley, was it Whitehall or Bexley? Right there on Main Street, they got the Jew section. And all their food is like...
The store, Giant Eagle even has a food.
Yeah, like... Their fruit juice or grape juice or whatever, everything's like $10 a bottle. It's super expensive.
Whoo, the hidden Jew tax.
If their potato chips at $6 a bag.
Stuff they turn around and take the time and money to take stuff out that isn't good, it's cheap. And they take the time to quit habits that aren't good for us. It's all about making money and experimenting with medical technology. So.
That's why there's so many people out here that got diabetes. You know what I mean? Half the food has high fructose.
Well, I don't look at diabetes as a disease. I look at it as more of a symptom that tells you you need to stay with your sugar because...
Right.
You're right. But it
people who aren't real physically active...
There's different levels of diabetes.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
You know, there is a beginning form that tells you better get yourself right.
A lot of people are misled about diseases and symptoms.
And that's fine. We was just talking about that before he came out here.
Yeah.
Because what's that old Greek... physician named Hippocrates. You ever hear the Hippocratic Oath or whatever? How do you say his name? Hippocrates?
Yeah. I mean,
there's an old saying that said, let thy food be thy medicine and thy medicine thy food.
How could man not know for hundreds of years that it's not better than alcohol? But alcohol's legal.
I'm just going to go back to that again.
Yeah, alcohol, yeah.
This is Ecclesiastes 38:12. Then give place to physicians, for the Lord hath created him. Let him not go from thee, for thou hast need of him. There is a time, and this ain't talking about the physician at OSU Hospital.
You know what the word physician means? It means natural. That's where you get the word physics, the laws of nature.
Yeah.
It means natural. So a real physician is not a doctor. A physician is somebody who uses, you know, natural means. They use herbs, you know.
Listen, there is a time when in their hands there is good success. For they shall also pray unto the Lord that he would prosper that which they give for ease and remedy to prolong life. He that sinneth before his maker, let him fall into the hand of the physician.
Yep.
Heavenly Son, my son, let tears fall down over the day and begin to lament. As if thou hast suffered great harm thyself, and then cover his body according to the custom and neglect not his burial. Weep bitterly and make great moan and use lamentation as he is worthy, and that a day or two least thou be evil spoken of, and then comfort thyself for thy heaviness. You know,
I wouldn't doubt
you know, just going pissing people off. They're using the military and our money.
Of course.
How many people you think, how many Jews you think died in 9/11?
We got money, we'll just pay all these people.
Yeah, kind of like speaking, no trying to be rude or anything like that, but we kind of like, we speaking, you know what I'm saying?
Trying to edify you.
Yeah, can't be interrupting us or stuff like that. No disrespect, man.
Yeah, I know I'm not trying to disrespect people either.
Yeah, but like the scripture I just read, you know, I mean, we all got family members that dropped dead from all kind of illness. You got to feel bad for them, man.
Yeah.
You know, you got to feel bad for them. Because we understand why and where it's coming from, you know.
My dad's sister just died yesterday of cancer.
Wow.
Yeah. It's probably the shit.
You know them curses, man.
Yeah, because our people, they don't want to listen to the laws of the Bible. The Bible said don't eat pork. Those fake Jews, they know better, they don't eat pork, you know?
Eat all kind of pork chops.
But when you go to the grocery store, which is all owned by Jews, by the way, it's fake Jews, what's the main meat they got up for sale? The pork, and it's cheap as hell. The pork's always cheaper than the beef.
It's always much more abundant.
And there's a greater abundance of pork than any other meat, because they want you to eat it. So,
right, and how many kind of edible fishes you can eat? And the fish market, the fish section is small as hell. You know?
Yep.
But that pork, man, goes on forever.
Oh, they got plenty of crab and lobsters for you, though.
Crab, lobster, shrimp.
Yeah, those are unlawful foods. You're not supposed to eat shrimp. You ain't supposed to eat no lobsters.
Those are foods for the wicked.
Yep.
Them motherfuckers cross the street on purpose, man. They don't want to pass by us.
That's good. That's good.
Man, you can just see people's
countenance
and see
that. That's a demon.
They see that bold. People see that bold spirit in us, man. You know. They see that boldness. And then you got that boldness with the spirit of the Lord, the Word, man. Ain't nobody gonna fuck with us, man.
Are you supposed to come out here all boldness?
Boldness.
I'm gonna get a script. I'm gonna do a search
and
on
curse boldness. These snakes out. Put curses on these snakes and crawdads.
Crawdads.
Right, crayfish. Don't bottom feeders.
Carp.
Right. And that's our people, man. They're bottom feeders. They take on all the philosophies. All that garbage. They take on all that garbage and vomit it on our people. You know?
Hey, I got a scripture. I'm talking about a boldness.
Ephesians?
There you go. Ephesians 3:12. In whom we have boldness and access with confidence by the faith of him.
Because we got the truth. And the truth, man, but just, whew. You know, what can we say, man? You got the truth. And you already know the truth can't be debunked.
And actually, naturally, I'm like a very shy person. I freak out around large crowds.
Me too.
I'm extremely shy.
But here we in front of the world.
But I come out here and I got no fear.
Boldness is a lie. Yep.
I would never come out here to talk about like regular stuff. Like come out here, you know, just mingling with strangers.
About what we did at the strip mall.
About I'm real shy, but when it comes to the scriptures, when I come out here and start teaching, the Lord just put the spirit on me and
you're on fire.
It just comes out.
Well, you're on fire.
Oh, let's get that. Psalms
1. It'd be a good reason for being shy. They'd be around the right crowd. Your senses detect, you know, the bad thing people.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
well, that's because we're not of this world, you know. The scriptures say you ain't supposed to be part of this world.
That's right.
We're not of this world, so the world rejects us.
You ever hung around you, like people at Shine season?
I hate them, yeah.
You ever notice how they only say like 2 or 3 words?
Yeah, didn't it?
Then they come up with these excuses, oh, we want to see what you think.
Well, it's part of their wicked...
The Talmud.
That they ain't supposed to talk to you in the first place.
Because, you know, they don't follow the Bible. They follow a book called the Talmud.
Right.
And the Talmud says, here, where's the...
You know, the Talmud tells you, if any Goyim ask a question, keep the word small and give them and deceive you. And that's just in their book. You know, to lie to you anyway. Or just not talk to you, period.
And you know, they're living off of our tax money.
Oh, of course. We know that.
John Cena's alone.
You.
Not let alone, you know, alone, not including the shifts in them, are worth $33 billion.
Right.
And they say,